Hello, everybody. This is Timmy-Fan again, and this is my second half of my moving diary. Well, after living with my mom for a couple of weeks after I moved back to Washington, I became so desperate for my own apartment or my own place to stay that I put an ad up on Craigslist and tried to find a place that way, and I got a few responses, and, well, some of them sounded very promising. I got a contact from one lady who bred Yorkshire Terriers, and I thought, wow, I'd be surrounded by puppies every season. That would have been cool. She was a nice person, a very nice person, and she had great-looking Yorkshire Terriers. Not an expert on Yorkies. I like them, but I'm not an expert on them. That was out probably mostly because I gave her the wrong phone number. I didn't give her the wrong phone number on purpose. That was an accident, believe me. I was staying at my ma's. I gave her her phone number, and frankly, I didn't know her number by heart by the time I went to that interview and filled out the application. Not long after, I heard from another woman, and she lived closer to Ocean Shores, which is where I used to live before I moved to Montana. She lived in Brady, actually. Her name was Patty. She lived in the country, and she had all kinds of chickens and all that good stuff. She had cats. She had one dog, a huge dog, that was a mongrel. Ugliest dang dog you ever seen in your life. But then again, today, most mongrels are. So I went to an interview with her, and I was like, this is a location that I would kill for. It's close to the ocean, but it's still close to where I can easily go shopping and go into town. And I thought that would be a great place. Plus, she lived in the country. And I love the country. What can I say? I thought, well, she'll let me have all the pets I want. So I went to an interview with her, and she was very nice. She told me that she did drink alcohol on occasion. She said that she did it occasionally. Like every once in a while, she would take a drink. I said, well, my father drinks beer, so I guess I can live with that. He's not a heavy drinker either. So as long as she wasn't a heavy drinker, I could live with that. My ma actually came with me, and she started to converse with Patty. Patty found out that ma loved British TV, so those two hit it off, because Patty loved British TV. I know almost nothing about British TV. My ma tells me about it, but I haven't caught on to that craze yet. I thought, well, I'll learn a little more about British TV living with Patty. Patty was very nice when I first met her, and she seemed just as determined as I was to make this thing work out. Said, yeah, we'll give it a try. So I was like, great, I can move in as early as Saturday evening. I had a little demo job. I was going to catch the bus to Olympia, stay with Ma. We would go off to our jobs, then I would go back to Patty's on Sunday morning. Well, that was how we planned it for that job. So Saturday, I did my demo job. I got off. When I got off, we went to the storage unit and I got some of my things out. I got my bed out. I got a few boxes out that I felt I needed. Got the dogs from the people who were taking care of them because I couldn't keep them at Ma's, and we were on our way. When I got there, Patty was really nice. She helped me with my things. She helped load the things into what would be my room. And everything was very good. I was very tired that day because I'd had a long day demoing and standing on my feet all day and trying to talk to people. And so all I really wanted to do was hit the sack. And I told Patty that. Next day, I started to get to know Patty. It was Sunday, so I got up and I started cooking breakfast for the both of us. Started cooking eggs and bacon and toast, and she liked hash browns, so I made that.
She liked sausage, so I made that. That was when I started to notice that she had a few quirks that I don't think I could have gotten used to even if I tried. Almost the instant I started making breakfast, when I was done with the bacon, she brought in her dog's food dish off of the back porch where all the animals shed their hair and feathers and take a dump and take a piss. She brought that dog's food dish inside from off the back porch, and she put it down on the cutting board right where I was preparing food. She wanted the bacon grease for the dog. So I didn't think much about it. I thought she would clean it up after she was done. She would clean off the cutting board. But she didn't do that. And then she asked me if I want toast, and I said, sure. So she takes out the bread, she unwraps it, she takes out two slices and immediately puts them into the toaster. And she pops down the toast. And then she took out two more pieces of bread and put them on the cutting board right in exactly the same spot where she had that dog's food dish. And I saw that and I was standing there thinking, oh, how disgusting! At that particular time, I didn't know that the dog's food dish sat outside. The only thing I did know was that there was hair all over the food dish. And that was disgusting. And so she took those two pieces of toast that popped out of the toaster right then, she put them on her plate. And then she took the two dirty slices and put them in the toaster. Well, I took the two clean slices off of her plate and I put it on my own. I was like, that's your damn dog. That's not my damn dog. I was like, I ain't gonna eat those slices. I wanted toast, but not that bad. I love animals, don't get me wrong, but I have limits to where I will put their paraphernalia, especially if it's all covered with hair and possibly crap. I will not put it where I prepare food. That was dirty. I couldn't even believe that a grown woman would do something like that. And another thing that I noticed about Patty, she had these big wide eyes and her pupils were always like little pinpricks, even in the dark. And that was kind of weird to me. I was thinking later on that she was probably a morphine addict. Well, the first day we got along pretty good. I started to notice she got a little silent after I took those pieces of toast off her plate. I wasn't about to eat the pieces that were in the toaster that had been on that cutting board. She did get a little bit silent, and I picked up on that, and I figured she's just pissed off because I ain't gonna eat those pieces of toast after her dog's food dish had been on them. She was kind of silent, but we still got along pretty good after that. I was still trying to get to know her. The next day was Monday and she had to go to work. She worked as a caregiver. She went to her morning shift. She did like that client very well because they got along great. They had a lot in common. She came home. She had gone to Taco Bell and had a couple of tacos and burritos with her. And she ate that. I just fixed myself something else because I hate Taco Bell. She was doing her thing. I was doing mine. So she went out after lunch and went to her afternoon shift. I asked her if she'd like to have anything that night for dinner, and she said French toast would be fine. So I figured I'll have some French toast ready for her, and she'll be happy. Well, I found out when she came back late that night that she didn't like that client because she said the husband was very controlling. So she was kind of in a bad mood. And I thought, well, she just had a bad day at work. I fixed her some French toast and I set it down in front of her. She fixed it up the way she liked it. And I sat beside her and we started to chit chat. I asked her how she liked the French toast because, you know, I'm new to making French toast. She said, I like it. And then she took another bite. She's like, didn't I already say that? And I said, I don't know, maybe. She said, I think I already said that. And she just went on. And I thought that was kind of rude of her to say that. But I didn't think anything of it, and I didn't mention anything about it, because, again, I thought she was having a rough night. We got into the subject of marriage and children. I asked her if she had any children, and she said, nope, was married, but she never had kids. She was grateful for that. I asked her how long she was married, and she said, too long. And she said that her husband was a beater. And I was like, oh, okay. So that ended that conversation there. She asked me if I ever had kids, and I said, nope. Been married, but never even tried to have kids. And she goes, huh, you led a boring life, haven't you? And I looked at her, and I thought she was kidding at first. And then I looked at her face, and I didn't see any sign of humor in it at all. And I was like, well, unless you count my travels, I guess you could say it is boring. I guess not boring to her is being married to some idiot that beats her. I've done things that probably she's never done before. But I thought that was kind of strange she would say something like that when she hadn't had kids herself. So, I didn't think anything of it. Again, I thought she's just having a bad night. She's in a bad mood. She had to work with a client she didn't particularly care for. Well, from that day on, it just kind of went downhill. The next day, she was really, really, really mean. It's like, she came up and got in my face at one point. She says, I'm not really accustomed to having to repeat myself to people. I need you to do this, and this, and this, and this. You know, they say in life you're supposed to pick your battles carefully. This woman, Patty, you say, hello, how are you doing today? And she would make that into a battle. I began to wonder if the reason her husband beat her wasn't because of him, that maybe it was because of her. Maybe she pestered him to death. And I'm unfortunately not the kind of person that you can say something once to and it sticks. I'm the kind of person that you have to repeat something to several times before it sticks. But my mind goes a million miles an hour, and if you say something to me once and I'm thinking of something else at that particular time when you tell me, it's not going to stick. So she didn't like that. So from that point on, she was mean and nasty and aggressive. And well, we went shopping, and I used my own money to buy a lot of food for the both of us, including her. And she got things that she wanted to get, and I got things that I wanted to get. She got pissed off because I bought food that she didn't like. And I said, don't you worry none about that. This is my money. This isn't yours. And she did get a lot of things on my money. She had no room to complain. But she just got meaner and meaner and meaner and meaner. And it was like every little thing set her off. She just got mean and nasty. I remember one time she went out to the barn and she wanted to show me how to open that metal door. Now, I'm not used to metal doors. We always had wooden ones. So I opened the door the way that I knew, the only way I could. And she said, that's not how you open a barn door. That's how you break a barn door. And she just went on in this nasty attitude. And I was like, okay. She was kind of loony. And she had these wide eyes, so she's very intimidating. Well, that night, I got a little bit hungry. And I started to fix myself a little snack. And I thought she was asleep. She came down those stairs, and she had this wild look in her eyes. And she's real angry. And I said, oh, I'm sorry, did I wake you? And I was like, I didn't mean to. I'll be out here in a minute. And she goes, what are you doing? And I said, I'm just fixing myself a little snack. She goes, you're going to eat that? It's too late. Don't eat that. She said, put it in Mulder's food dish. Mulder was the dog. That's too bad. Give him the food. You're not going to eat that before bed. And I looked in her eyes. It was dark in there. She would not allow me to turn on any lights. And she had this wild look in her face. She had these big wide eyes. She had these pinprick pupils. And she just looked scary. And she was acting nutty, and she was just going off in a wild tangent.